Hello, children. This is Rajni ma'am. Welcome to the class 4th standard, subject mathematics. This is continuation of unit 3 and the unit name is review of basic numerical operations. So in last class, we have discussed the subheading of the division and we have solved the examples. Today we are going through the exercise. So the first main, divide the following. Here the number is given, we have to divide and write the quotient and remainder. So the given number is 56 divided by 2. So solution, first we'll write the solution. The given number we'll write, that is 56 divided by 2. The division is shown in the rough column to the right side. That is 56 divided by 2. So here 2 is a divisor. 56 is a dividend and we have to find the quotient and remainder. So here divisor is 2, so we have to do the 2 table. So first number is 5. We should take the number equal to 5 or less than 5. So 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6. So 2 threes are 6 is more than 5. So we take 2 twos are 4. So now we'll subtract 5 and 4. From 5, if we subtract 4, we get answer 1. Next, we write the number. Next, we pull down the number 6. Now it becomes 16. So here, 16 is a, we should check whether it is divisible in 2 or no. So here, 16 is a divisible by 2 table. That is 2 8s are. 2 8s are is 16. So here 16 is exact divisible by 2 table. That is 2 8s are is 16. So 16 minus 16 is 0. So here we are getting the remainder 0 and quotient is 28. Okay. For the given number 56 divided by 2, we are getting the remainder here 0 and quotient is 28. Okay. For the given number, that is 56 is a dividend, 2 is a divisor. Here we are getting the remainder 0 and the quotient is 28. So therefore, for the given number 56 divided by 2, which is equal to 28. So therefore, the quotient is equal to 28, that is Q, and the remainder R, which is equal to 0. The next second one. Here the given number is 196 divided by 5. So solution, first we write the given number, that is 196 divided by 5. So the division is shown in the rough column to the right side. That is 196 divided by 5. Here 196 is a dividend and 5 is a divisor. So we should find the quotient and remainder. So first we take the number 19 and we check. The divisor is here 5. So we read the 5 table. We take the number less than 19 or equal to 19. So 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10. 5 threes are 15. 5 fours are 20. Here 5 fours are is 20. 20 is greater than 19. So we take 5 threes are 15. So we write 15 and now we subtract it. So that is from 9, if you subtract 5, we get answer 4. 1 minus 1 is 0. Next, we pull down the number 6. Now it is 46. So we read the 5 table. The number should be less than 46 or equal to 46. So 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, 5 fives are 25, 5 six are 30, 5 sevens are 35, 5 eights are 40, 5 nines are 45, 5 tens are 50. So less than 46 means 5 nines are 45. We should take. So we write the 45 and we subtract it now. So from 6, if we subtract 5, we get answer 1. Next 4 minus 4 is 0. So here we are getting the remainder as 1 and the quotient as 39. So for the dividend 196 and the divisor 5, we are getting the remainder 1 and the quotient 39. So therefore 196 divided by 5, which is equal to 39. Here the question Q, which is equal to 39, and the remainder R, which is equal to 1. The next, the third one. The given number is 478 divided by 2. So first we write the solution. The given number we write, that is 478 divided by 2. So the division is shown in the rough column to the right side. That is 478 divided by 2. Here 478 is a dividend and 2 is a divisor. We should find the quotient and remainder. So here divisor is 2. So we read the 2 table. That is 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6. So first number is 4. We should take the number equal to 4 or less than 4. So 2 twos are 4, 2 twos are 4 is direct divisible by 2. So 2 twos are 4 we take. So we subtract now, 4 minus 4 is 0. Next we pull down the number 7. So next we read the table 2 again. That is 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8. 2 fours is 8. Here the given number is what? Here the number is 7. 7 means we should take equal to 7 or less than 7. So 2 threes is 6. 2 fours is 8. 8 is greater than 7. So we take 2 threes are 6. So from 7, if we subtract 6, we get answer 1. Next we pull down the number 8. Now it becomes 18. 18 means here 18 is exact divisible by 2 by 9. That is 2 nines is 18. So here 18 is exact divisible by 2. That is 2 nines are 18. So we write 18. Now we subtract from 18. If we subtract 18, we get answer 0. So for the given dividend 478 and divisor 2, we are getting here remainder, that is 0, and the quotient is 239. So therefore 478 divided by 2, which is equal to 239. Here, therefore, the quotient is Q, which is equal to 239, and the remainder R, which is equal to 0. The next fourth one, here the given number is 259 divided by 4. So first we write the given number solution, that is 259 divided by 4. The division is shown in the rough column to the right side. That is 259 divided by 4. So here the divisor is 4 and the dividend is 259. So the divisor is 4 and dividend is 259. We have to find the remainder and quotient. So first here the divisor is 4. So we read the 4 table. We take the two numbers, that is 25 first. So 2 ones are, that is 4, 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, 4 fours are 16, 4 fives are 20, 4 six are 24, 4 sevens are 28. So here 28 is more than 25. So we take the lesser number, that is 4 six is 24. So we write 24 and now we subtract it. From 5 we subtract 4, we get answer 1. 2 minus 2 is 0. Next we pull down the number 9. Now it becomes 19. So we take the next number equal to 19 or less than 19. So 4 fours are 16, 4 fives is 20. 20 is greater than 19. So we take 4 fours are 16. So from 9, if we subtract 6, we get answer 3. 1 minus 1 is 0. So on dividing 259 divided by 4, we are getting here remainder 3 and a quotient 64. Okay. For the given dividend 259 and the divisor 4, we are getting the remainder as 3 and the quotient as 64. So therefore 259 divided by 4, which is equal to 64. So therefore quotient Q is equal to 64 and remainder R is equal to 3. So the next second main, fill the blanks. So the first one, 36 divided by 1, which is equal to dash. So when 36 is divided by 1, we get answer, that is question 36. So 36 divided by 1, which is equal to dash, means 36. 136 is 36. So the question we are getting is 36. Next, 0 divided by number other than 0 gives dash. So when you take any number and divide it by 0, or 0 divided by any number, Okay. When you take 0 and divide by any number, we get the answer that is 0. So therefore, 0 divided by any number other than 0 gives 0. So 0 divided by 10, which is equal to 0. 0 divided by 25, which is equal to 0. So if you take 0 and divide by any other number other than 0, we get answer as 0. Okay. So therefore, 0 divided by a number other than 0 gives 0. Next, third one. The quotient obtained on dividing 36 by 3, which is equal to dash. So when 36 is divided by 3, we are getting quotient. We have to find it. So 36 divided by 3, that is in 3 table, 36 goes by 12. That is 3 12s is 36. So here we are getting the quotient 12. So when 36 is divided by 3, the quotient obtained, that is Q, which is equal to 12. So therefore, quotient obtained on dividing 36 by 3, which is equal to 12. Based on the exercise, the assessment is given. So solve the exercise problems and solve the given assessment. The first main, divide the following numbers. The first one, 112 divided by 9. The second one, 125 divided by 5. The third one, 102 divided by 3. The fourth one, 48 divided by 4. The fifth one, 145 divided by 5. Okay, children, go through the exercise, solve the problems and practice it, and solve the given assessment. We'll continue the next unit in the next video part. Thank you.